You're watching Tag TV.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Yeshi, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of our country's diversity. With India being a land of festivals and celebrations, each day is a festival in India. Recently, the festival of Rakuna Rath Yatra was celebrated in Bhubaneswar. Observed on Ashokashtami, the festival is believed to be destroyer of all evils and sins. Though celebrated with great enthusiasm, this year it was organized with adherence to all COVID-19 SOPs.
A significant festivity at famous Lingaraja temple, Rukuna Rath Yatra is a celebration of the indigenous culture and traditions of Odisha. Celebrated in month of Chaitra on Shukla Ashtami, which coincides with the Gregorian month of April-May, the festival is celebrated with huge pomp and show every year, with thousands of devotees flocking the procession to offer their prayers to Lord Lingaraj. However, this year, amid the spike in coronavirus cases, the chariot festival was carried out without devotees under the supervision of authorities and police personnel.
Due to COVID-19, this year, Lord Sri Lingaraj, this annual Rath Yatra festival is being conducted without devotees. The center stage 144 prevention order has been promulgated and no devotees are being allowed to come out.
A grand chariot made of wood was constructed for the festival. It was decorated in shades of red, yellow and orange using cloth and flower garlands and was detailed with intricate floral and tribal designs painted on it. Priests performed rituals and chanted prayers in praise of Lord Lingaraj, who is considered an incarnation of Lord Shiva, the Hindu god of destruction. As this year, only priests and a few people who had tested negative for COVID-19 were allowed to participate in the procession, local residents witnessed it only from their homes.
इसलिए रथ यात्रा भी नहीं हुआ था बट आज रथ यात्रा देख पा रहे हैं बिकॉज हम लोग सुरक्षित घर पे ही हैं।
रुकुना रथ यात्रा इज ऑल्सो बिलीव्ड टू बी पाप विनाशकारी यात्रा मीनिंग अ फेस्टिवल दैट डिस्ट्रॉयज और इरेडिकेट्स ऑल ईविल्स एंड सिंस। According to the legend, in the Treta Yuga, Lord Rama visited Ekamrukshetra, now known as Bhubaneswar, in Chaitra and stayed at the Rameshwara temple as a guest of Lord Lingaraja, who along with his family visited Lord Rama to wish him on his birthday, the Ram Navami. From this significant visit, this festival originated. Lasting for nearly 5 to 7 days, during the festival, the Rath is drawn by the devotees from Lingaraja Temple to Rameswara Temple and starts its return journey from 5th day. Bhuvaneshwar, also known as the City of Temples, celebrates many more such festivals to cherish the culture and ancient heritage of the region.
The COVID-19 pandemic has united the whole country into one family, whose each and every member is contributing its bit to sail through these hard times. But a few among them have just changed the definitions of compassion and empathy with their extraordinary efforts and have become an inspiration for all. So today, we take you to meet the volunteers of two NGOs, one based in Pune and other in Bengaluru, who have stepped in to give COVID-19 victims a dignified send-off, no matter which caste or community they belong to. Have a look.
COVID-19 has posed several challenges before the country, among which performing the last rites of the patients who succumb to the disease is the major one. In many cases, the family of a deceased is in quarantine itself, while in few, the family may not be willing to accept the body of the patient as the contamination levels are too high and there are even chances of fatal infection if not handled with care. In such a situation, Samaritans across Indian cities have taken upon themselves to carry out the funeral ceremonies of COVID-19 patients whose bodies are refused by their families for their last rites. Few among them are the volunteers of a Pune-based NGO, Unmat Foundation, who cremate the bodies handed over by the hospitals. They even find out the religion of the deceased and perform the last rites according to their religious customs.
कई बार जब फैमिलीज बॉडी एक्सेप्ट नहीं करते तो एक छोटा सा पुलिस फॉर्मेलिटी करने के बाद हॉस्पिटल वो बॉडी हमको ट्रांसफ़र कर देती है, हमको हैंडओवर कर देती है और वो बॉडी हमारे पास आने के बाद हम लोग अगर वो हिंदू होगा तो हिंदू शास्त्र के अनुसार उसका अंतिम विधि करते और अगर मुस्लिम होगा तो मुस्लिम शास्त्रों के अनुसार उसका अंतिम विधि करते।
The volunteers of Mercy Angels, an offshoot of a Bengaluru-based NGO, Mercy Mission, are also working on the same lines. They have been relentless in their service ever since the pandemic strengthened its grip in the country. Many of the volunteers have even caught this infectious disease a number of times. But still, they are undeterred in their efforts to serve the society.
I am not scared anymore because I already tested positive 4 times last time when we were doing the last season, last year. So many of us have tested, I'm sure, the volunteers, the frontline volunteers. So I'm not scared. I just want to help people get a dignified burial.
Rising above religious biases and working with only motive to serve the humanity, this is what these volunteers have been doing. Their work is inspiration for everyone to come forward and help the country at this time of need.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently. Authorities in India's central Bhopal city have converted a train into a 300-bedded isolation facility in a move to aid the country's health system. Workers were seen giving final touches to an Indian Railways train that will serve as a quarantine facility for dozens of people, with air coolers to beat the heat of the summer. With hospitals in the country's main cities unable to guarantee basic services, some regions are coming up with makeshift solutions to stop the system from buckling amid the pandemic. Police are being deployed to secure oxygen, and in court, judges are challenging the central government to do more to address shortages. As hospitals in New Delhi scramble to find oxygen supplies, the Sikh community in the outskirts of Indian capital is giving a new lease of life to COVID-19 patients gasping for breath by providing oxygen langar or free oxygen supply. Members of a Sikh temple, Gurdwara Sri Guru Singh Sabha Indirapuram in northern Ghaziabad city, along with a non-governmental organization Khalsa Help International, have started the unique initiative to help the patients out by providing free oxygen to patients whose saturation levels have dropped significantly.
लोगों को गाड़ी में लेके आइए, सारे जो पेशेंट हमें पता है कोविड है, तो इस करके कोविड पेशेंट को ना आपको बाहर निकालना ना आपको अंदर बिठाना, हम गाड़ी में ही मास्क लगा के आपको ये सेवा दे रहे हैं, हमारी कालजाल इंटरनेशनल और उसके अलावा लोगों की टेस्टिंग, दवाइयाँ, लंगर, इस कोविड की महामारी में सारी सेवा इस गुरुद्वारे से दी जा रही है.
Long queues of patients and their relatives were spotted in the temple premises as the news about the initiative spread on social media, with many applauding them and many offering their help to the cause. The volunteers claim that they have been able to provide oxygen to 200 to 250 patients so far. It has been said that humanity is the virtue that stands above all religions and caste. Examples of citizens doing noble deeds amid these tough times of COVID-19 pandemic can be found in every nook and corner of the nation. So today, we bring you two such examples where citizens are going an extra mile to help the needy. Take a look.
Feeding a hungry person is nothing less than a virtue. With the coronavirus pandemic putting up many challenges in front of the authorities, feeding the hungry remains a tough one. Extending a helping hand in such a scenario are the members of the Delhi Sikh Gurudwara Management Committee, who are preparing langar or free food for COVID-19 patients and families that are facing a crisis of food scarcity.
इस बारी लोगों की सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम ये आ रही है कि हर घर के अंदर सारे पेशेंट हो रहे हैं. अगर चार बंदे घर में रहते हैं तो चारों के चारों कोविड पॉजिटिव आ रहे हैं, और मैं समझता हूं कि ये जिम्मेवारी गुरुद्वारा कमेटी की थी कि जो पॉजिटिव लोग हैं, जिनको घरों में रोटी नहीं बना सकते, जो बाहर निकल के अपनी सामग्री नहीं खरीद सकते, वो लोगों के लिए हमने यह सुविधा शुरू की है कि पैक फूड यहाँ से जाएंगे. और ये कोविड पॉजिटिव के लिए, जो लंगर की प्रथा हमारी चल रही है वो अलग चल रही है, मगर ये कोविड पॉजिटिव के लिए जो पेशेंट्स होंगे, जो परिवार होंगे, उनको ये लंगर पहुंचाने का काम हमने ये शुरू किया.
वॉलंटियर्स इंक्लूडिंग बोथ मेन एंड वुमेन आर प्रिपेयरिंग एंड पैकिंग फूड ऑन अ मास स्केल इन द किचन ऑफ न्यू दिल्लीज famous Sikh shrine, Bangla Sahib Gurudwara, to distribute them among the needy people. The members of the committee have also issued a toll-free helpline number where the patients could contact and get free food after producing the COVID-19 positive report.
यहाँ पर कल हमारे पास तकरीबन 700 लोगों की कॉल्स आई हैं, और 700 के घरों में ये लंगर पहुँचाने का काम किया है. हमारी जो टीम्स हैं दिल्ली के चारों तरफ, हमारे राइडर्स जाते हैं, और अब लंगर, क्योंकि कई जगह पर ऐसे है कि अगर जमुना पार से कोई कॉल आई है तो उनके वहाँ पर दो परिवारों को चाहिए, तो वो दो के लिए भी जाएंगे. अगर वेस्ट दिल्ली में 10 परिवारों को चाहिए तो 10 के भी जाएंगे.
At present, when the whole country is in the grip of the pandemic, in such a situation, a number of people cutting across the religious lines are coming forward and contributing their bit to help those in need.
India is witnessing a surge in new breed of young singers and musicians who are not just working on various genres of music but are also blending them to create something unique. One among them is Jammu and Kashmir-based singer-cum-music composer Rasik Imtiaz Khan, whose compositions are gaining traction among youngsters in the Kashmir Valley. Have a look.
With a guitar in their hands and music in heart, many Kashmiri youngsters have come of age while striking the musical notes with their niche audience. They are stepping into various music genres, blending and mixing them to create something that will make them stand out from the crowd. Moving on the same trail is a Budgam resident, Rasik Imtiaz Khan, who has become the talk of the town due to his love for music. A graduate from Kashmir University, Khan says he became passionate about singing and music ever since he listened to Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan.
एक बार एक मतलब नुसरत फतेह अली खान साहब को उनकी आवाज मेरे कानों में गई तो उस दिन से देखा मैंने मतलब कुछ अलग ही गया कानों में. उसके पहले भी मैं सुनता था गाने लेकिन मुझे वो मज़ा नहीं आता था और जब वो चीज़ मैंने सुनी तो मेरा इंटरेक्शन बढ़ गया तो इसी वजह से फिर मैं इस फील्ड में आ गया.
After Khan was determined to make his career in music, his struggle began. He approached many studios to get his songs recorded, but they were all out of his budget. Dejected, he thought to open his own recording and editing studio with the limited funds that he had. Once he had a studio, Khan started making music across different genres along with popularizing his own Kashmiri roots.
मैं चाहता था मैं अपने गाने प्रोवाइड करूं मार्केट में. मेरे लिए खुद को मेरे पास कोई इक्विपमेंट नहीं था ताकि मैं अपने गाने खुद प्रोवाइड कर सकूं. तो अगर मैं किसी लोकल स्टूडियो में भी जाना चाहता था तो मुझे ज़्यादा चार्ज किया जाता था. तो उस वजह से फिर एक वक्त मेरे लिए ऐसा आया एक मैंने फिर अपना एक स्टूडियो खुद मतलब खुद का स्टूडियो आज अभी यहाँ पे हम डिफरेंट जॉनर्स बनाने की कोशिश करते हैं लाइक जो इंडिया में भी बनाते हैं और मुंबई में भी बनाते हैं मगर कश्मीर में अभी तक नहीं बना है. उनमें रैगेटन आता है, डबस्टेप आता है, EDM आता है और ऑल ओवर इंडियन क्लासिकल तो आता ही है और खुद का जो कश्मीर का अपना कल्चर है वो भी हम प्रोवाइड करते हैं और ये हम कुछ नया कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे जो कि बाहर होता है वो जब यहाँ हो रहा है.
Today, Rasik Imtiaz Khan is not just composing and recording his own songs, but he has also become a ray of hope for the budding singers in the valley. He completely support their talent and even record and edit their songs free of cost.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about recent developments and happenings from around the world in our new edition, World in Focus. Bicycle riding is gaining immense popularity in Japan, especially among the youngsters. For helping these newbies in learning bicycle riding efficiently, Yamaha Motor Sales has come up with the Yamaha Riding Academy, where youngsters are taught the basics of motorcycle riding. These bicycles are used for teaching people how to ride bikes. The bicycles used during the training process are equipped with a device that measures GPS logs to obtain data on position, speed and acceleration during driving. After the first run, the driving data is obtained from the measurement device and then the instructor advises the rider for better driving.
ライダーの技量に合わせて、今のレベルを可視化して、じゃあどこを重点的にトレーニングしたらいいのかというメニューをきちっとアドバイスシートに出した中で、エビデンスを残しながら指導ができるというのが強みになりますので、やっぱり GPS ロガーを使って収集したデータを、 分析をしてでフィードバックするここの、ノウハウが、まあ、強みになっているかと思いますね。こう生涯顧客化ということでバイクを楽しんでいただくための活動をこれからもやっていきたいなと思っています。
Yamaha's accumulated know-how as a pioneer in motorsport help riders around the world. Bike lessons like these will also be organized in China and Thailand. Next, we present you a soft ice cream called Hakkai that has a unique relationship with Mount Fuji, the highest mountain in Japan. Oshino Hakkai is a tourist spot at the foot of Mount Fuji. It has a pond with a crystal clear water in it and is visited by a number of tourists every year. The place has a souvenir shop, Ikumoto, that sells Hakkai soft ice cream introduced by Nissei. The ice cream has flavors like matcha, peach, muscat. It tastes like ramyun, which is similar to the taste of soda. Japanese company Nissei endeavors to develop a characteristic soft ice cream to make customers and foreign tourists happy. Swedish payments firm Klarna has added a carbon footprint tracker to its shopping app, offering each of its 90 million users the option of monitoring the environment impact on their consumption. From production to delivery at a shopper's front door, the feature will display an estimated carbon emission of each purchase and allow users to track their cumulative carbon footprint over months. The firm, which counts retail giants H&M, Asos and Nike among its quarter of a million clients, said users will currently only see the emissions after a purchase, but it hopes to update the app so it is shown in advance. The emissions will be shown in kilograms of CO2, but will also be compared to energy burning activities such as a car journey of a certain distance, so the cost can be better understood. An initiative is turning a school in the Saudi city of Aluna into an artistic hub where 60 women artisans are learning to become pioneers of the country's growing creative economy. Established in June 2020, the training was held at Aldira School in collaboration between Turquoise Mountain Foundation and the Royal Commission for Aluna to help support the talents of young women in various traditional crafts. This include pottery, textile, jewelry design and palm wicker design.
درست هذه الحرفة في الجامعة وحبيت اني اطور منها وعشان افتح فيها بزنس خاص فيني والتحقت بمركز تركواز لتدريب حرفة السيراميك والفخار وان شاء الله يعني استمر فيها واحصل على التدريب المناسب.
The initiative is announced as part of a major master plan unveiled by Saudi authorities late last week to position Aluna as a main destination for cultural tourism in the region. That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Yeshi and it's goodbye from the entire production team.